sir. My name is Pranjal. Sir, I want to ask, like, why 60 is a benchmark for retirement? Sir, High Court judges have 65, professors have 62.
You ask a very relevant question, and you provided the answer just last month. You increase the age from 60 to 65.
So that means
so anybody up to the age of 65 can join the national pension system.
Very good, sir. Thank you for those words. My name is Dhruv Dan, and I've got two very naive questions. One is, what if in the middle of those early investments, if we start off early investments, what if, say, we take a detour from our jobs and we do not have a steady income, and we tend to not pay for those period of time? Is there any penalty or any adverse effect apart from losing out on some amount of money that we have? That is the first one. The second one is, if you have the entire pension scheme there, how do we save out on taxes as far as pension scheme is concerned? Those are two questions.
Yeah. Good questions. Now, you know, it happens quite often. In fact, this is a fairly plausible situation where, you know, people sometimes are out of work for some periods of time and all that. But, you know, this is one of the good things about the NPS. You can continue the NPS without contributing for a period of time. So, you know, our requirement is that in a year, you are supposed to put in just 1,000 rupees in a year. But in case you miss that, it's not as if you are ejected from the system. You can remain in the system. We earlier had a penalty of, you know, bringing people back in the system if they had defaulted or they missed on some. But we removed that. So there's no penalty. You can stay in the system and continue. But the only thing is, like, if you've missed 1 year or 2 years, then to restart, you have to pay the minimum 2 years contribution, that 1,000 rupees per month. You don't have to pay any penalties on that. So that's been, we removed that about a year back, you know, because we are getting this feedback from the market that, you know, people are not always regularly employed. So these kind of situations could arise when, you know, people are temporarily out of jobs and then they're faced with a situation like this. And this second point was on the, what are that?
Tax saving,
yeah. In fact, tax saving wise, NPS is probably the best product in the market today. I'll tell you why. So we have this the usual ATC benefits, 1.5 lakhs is there in the income. In addition to that, the government, a year before last, gave us an additional 50,000 benefit under ATC CD 1B. So this is the only scheme which has this additional 50,000. So, you know, you could exhaust your 1.5 lakhs in the ATC, and if you still wanted to save tax, and if you had taxable income, then you could put in up to 50,000 rupees, which would be deducted from your taxable income in NPS. You know? So this is the only product which has this additional tax benefit. So these are the tax benefits.
Good evening, sir. My name is Siddharth, and my question is regarding the fund managers that you mentioned. In terms of security, how does pension from regulatory and development authority takes an overview of the fund managers that are handling all the investments made by us?
Yeah, so, you know, I said that our funds are managed by professional fund managers. So we select them on a weighting basis, and we have 8 fund managers at present. And see, what we do is we lay down the policy. We give them the do's and the don'ts of investment. And they are not supposed to deviate from that. They have to stick to that. And these rules have been made keeping, you know, the safety features in mind. So, you know, there are some concentration limits and exposure limits and things like that. So we set the rules for them. And what kind of ratings, you know, they have to rate it. They can only invest in rated securities. And so we laid out all these ground rules for them. So within that, they invest within the guidelines set by them. So that's how it works here. And we are able to get good returns from the investments.
Good evening.
evening, sir. My name is Bhavna. I want to ask the question that you mentioned that we would be getting around 58 lakh at the end of 60 years of our life. I wanted to ask, you mentioned that 18 lakh would be the amount that we would be paying and 40 lakh would be what we would be getting. So whether this is adjusted for the present value, because sometimes it happens that the amount that you are paying and the amount that you are getting equals when you consider them in real terms.
No, this is the nominal amount that you'll get. See, I give you the example of a person joining the scheme at the age of 25 and contributing 2,000 rupees per month into the pension scheme, and that contribution of 2,000 rupees per month would earn a return of 9% per annum. So, on these assumptions, the amount that that person would get at the age of 60 would be that 58 lakhs. Now, what I was saying was that, you know, the actual contribution made by him, the 2,000 rupees per month over a period of 35 years would be just about 18 lakhs or so. And 40 lakhs would come by way of the interest, the earnings that would be generated on these contributions. Now, if you were to do a present value analysis, why do you do that? Because you want to have a certain figure in mind that at the age of 60, I'd like to have this much of a return to ensure that I'm able to, you know, maintain a certain kind of lifestyle and all that. Now, for that, you have to plan it out. Like, you know, so you have to, what you have to do is you take your current income and you project it over, say, their entire working life, which is not a very easy exercise, mind you, because here we are talking about 20, 25, 30 years. But take an estimate of that, taking into account the fact that, you know, there would be increases every year and all that, you factor in all that. Then you factor in the expenses that you'd be incurring. So if your income, say, at the start, at the age of 25, let's say, what, 50, 60,000 rupees a month, you're spending, say, 20-25,000 rupees a month, then the expenses, because of the inflation and all that, say 6 or 7%, that would also go on, you know, increasing every year. And then at the end of at the age of 60, say after 35 years, what would those expenses amount to? So to take care of those expenses, you would have to have a certain income. So that is the income target that you have to keep in mind, you know. And to achieve that kind of an income, what kind of saving do you need? You have to work backwards like that, you know, and arrive at the amount. It's not very difficult, it can be done quite easily. Nowadays these calculators are all available, very simple to do.
Good evening, sir. So my question is, suppose I start investing at the age of 25, but due to some personal problems, I need money when I am 40 years old. So is it possible that I can withdraw my money from NPS scheme at that time, or is there any minimum time that you have to invest the money for?
Yeah, it's a good question. What we do is, we discourage people to withdraw from the pension corpus, you know, pension account, because the moment you withdraw some amount, then that is removed from the corpus which is invested, and therefore, you know, your returns are affected because of that. But we recognize also the fact that people would need money for certain contingencies. So for certain specific reasons, like say a serious illness or education of children or for purchase of a house or for marriage of children, you know, for certain 5 or 6 specified reasons, we permit 25% of the person's contribution to be withdrawn. We allow that to happen. But beyond that, we discourage people from withdrawing, because then it ultimately affects their, you know, the retirement amount and the pension that you would ultimately get. But we do provide for these contingencies.
So 25% is the maximum that a person can get.
So, compared to government pension schemes and private pension schemes, except the risk factor that the government schemes are protected by the government and private are not thrown into any protection, what are the advantages does the government pension scheme enjoy?
By government pension scheme, we mean the NPS, the scheme that we are running, NPS. Because the government scheme also, there's an old government pension scheme. See, I'll give you a bit of background to this. What happened was that I spoke about that committee which was set up to look into, you know, the issues of the pension sector in this country. So at that point of time, all government servants were enjoying what is known as a defined benefit pension scheme, which was not a contributory scheme. Government servants didn't have to contribute a paisa to the pension scheme. The government gave them an assured pension when they retired at the age of 60. But this was proving to be very burdensome on the government. But every year, you know, the number of pensioners was increasing year after year, and the government had to meet this pension bill from the budget. So one of the things that this committee also looked into was, you know, how to take care of this increasing burden on the government on account of pension. So that's why they came up with this contributory scheme. Ours is a contributory pension scheme, which in so all government employees who joined service from 1/1/2004 became members of our scheme. And this was the contributory scheme. They contributed 10% of the salary. The government contributes 10% of the salary. So 20% of a person's salary is invested every month. This is the new scheme. Under the old scheme, all those people who were in government service before 1/1/2004 continue to enjoy the benefit under the old scheme, where they get an assured pension roughly of 50% of the last drawn pay as a pension. But under the new scheme, all those who joined after 1/1/2004, they are members of our NPS. And the amount of pension that they get will depend on the, you know, the kind of corpus that they build up at the age of 60. So this is the difference between the two. Matter whether you are working abroad or not. So long as you are a citizen of the country, you can remain in the scheme.